Halo is good, and I like it a lot. Thank you, Leva. Halo means a lot to me, and this video is going to be my discussion on exactly what I like. And what I hate.
Getting rusty.
Now I'm gonna try to be as reasonable as I can with my critical evaluation by keeping my feelings, nostalgia, and biases in check. Mind you, this is all thanks to my dad whenever he gave me an Xbox with a copy of Halo 2 and basically said, "Have fun, I'm going to Germany." That and some other games like Batman Begins, Need for Speed, and Madden. But Halo 2 was just amazing. Like, I played the campaign over and over and over. Like, I know a lot of people are judging by saying, "Oh, you should have played Halo CE first to truly appreciate Halo 2. And to that I say, shut the fuck up. Look, I first played this game back in like 2005, and it was my favorite game ever. And now it's 2023, and Halo is a little different now. Anyway, let us be. Before that, I should specify that we're gonna talk about the campaign, not the multiplayer, the campaign.
Yes, sir. I need a weapon.
Right this way.
That's what I'm talking about! That's why he's the MVP! That's why he's the GOAT!
I don't even know what to say about the multiplayer, because back then, I was lonely. I still am, just much more so back then. I also never had Xbox Live until Halo Reach. So I never had the true Halo 2 multiplayer experience until MCC, which I'm not gonna talk about. And we all know why. I will also make an attempt to avoid spoilers, but to be fair, this game is over a decade old now, so if you haven't played this because you're still grinding pinnacles on Destiny, that's your own fault. Anyway, let us begin.
Pretty good.
The year is 2004. People are lined up and down the street to get their hands on a copy of Halo 2, the very anticipated sequel to the masterpiece that was Combat Evolved. This game is what made Halo a serious contender in the gaming atmosphere, with the Halo Man, Master Chief, being Xbox's poster boy, and new character, the Arbiter, creating one of the first interactive cinematic gaming experiences. Or, in other words, this game is fucking cool. Seriously, like, you look at a dictionary and Halo 2 is next to the word cool. Like, boom, there it is. You had to be there, man. Like, Halo 2 was the shit. Like, holy shit, this game is too good. The shooting, the vehicles, the graphics, like, what the fuck? The story is badass. The sounds are impactful and the music is just... Considering how Halo 2 had a really bad development cycle, you'd expect the game to have some bugs, or maybe some glitches. And you'd be right. But you're also wrong. An example would be how the Jackal snipers have literally aimbot on legendary mode, but no one really complained about it since it's just a good game. Like, the AI in Halo 2 was way ahead of its time. Like, some games today are just struggling to have that good of compatible AI. Like, it's kind of funny to me that people genuinely say, "Oh, Call of Duty is so much better than Halo." And to that I say, sure, the multiplayer is more rewarding, I'll give you that. But when you tell me that the mission crash site from Black Ops is better than Metropolis, then to me you're just brain dead and a bandwagon rider. You see, in almost every Halo game, the experience will be very different depending on your equipped weapons, the enemies in that mission, and the overall mission design. The enemies in Halo 2 are placed strategically to challenge the player into thinking about future events like, should I use this rocket launcher here?
No. Wait.
Or save my ammo for the next big guy. Every enemy has different weaknesses and can be exploited if the correct weapon is used. Also, the grunts are just hilarious.
Me like elites. Brutes stinky bad. Me stay here, make sure no brutes come behind, mighty Arbiter.
Let me give you an example, right? In the mission Black Ops, the crash site mission that I mentioned earlier, you're on a boat for half the mission and on foot for the other half. You get a grenade launcher towards the end and shoot down some helicopters.
Oh, brother, this guy stinks!
Whereas in Halo 2's Metropolis mission, you start the mission with a tank, or a Warthog, or a Ghost, or a Banshee. You get what I'm saying. Maybe I don't want to use the tank. Maybe I want to use the Warthog since it's faster and I'm not as big of a target. These choices can influence the way a warfight goes in the mission, because your choice might have a solution to a fight that's entirely different from somebody else's. Like, I genuinely don't get it. Like, how does someone say this? It's better than this.
That's right, you mothers! Run!
If someone says that Halo 2's outskirts is hard, then they're right, because fuck that guy. So basically, Halo Man has better gameplay than the numbers guy. That's the point. That's great. As for Halo 2's story, it's another aspect of the game that I'll admit could have been ironed out a little bit more. But for that, it makes up for it with... I remember when I was 7 years old and I got to this level, and I was terrified simply because of the level design. Like, as soon as I beat the Arbiter, I'd either skip all the levels and go straight into Delta Halo, or just play Batman.
Ah shit, this game is scary too!
This was all thanks to the atmosphere of the game. It's games like these that can make you feel a certain way and impact the way you care about what's going on in the story. Halo 2 does this with the level design and the music I mentioned earlier, so that you can make your own assumptions about what's going on, rather than...
This is bad. Real bad.
Yeah, no shit.
Like, here's some examples without trying to spoil anything.
Oh, this place is kind of scary. Oh, shit.
Whoa. Oh, this is nice. Yeah, I like this. Oh, wow, yeah. Oh, look at the fishes. Look at the fishes, they're everywhere.
Oh no, no, I wanna go home.
Bungie was pretty good at environmental storytelling, and they still are today. Like, I can't say it enough, Halo 2's world conveys so much information with saying so little. Now, you probably noticed that I haven't been talking about Halo 2 Anniversary. To be fair, I haven't, but that's because the studio responsible for the remaster of Halo 2 is also responsible for this.
Why the fuck is it so bright in here?
So yeah, for the sake of me ranting and publicly displaying my own opinion, I'd rather not discuss the remaster. What I will say is that it's an improvement on how they handled Combat Evolved.
I still can't see anything!
And that most of the new character designs look really good. But personally, I'd rather play on the classic settings. Anyway, back to Halo 2. That's only one half of Halo 2. This is the other half. It's these quiet moments that make you appreciate the game's pacing, where it can tell you to slow down, smell the roses for a bit, showing off the game's world without saying anything, and then throwing you back into the gun slaughter to make sure you're not bored. Overall, Halo 2 is pretty fun. It's engaging and emotional, and Bungie went through development hell trying to get this game out the door. And although it shouldn't have happened, it was well worth it. For a long time, this game was my number one game to play, and I still regard it as one of my favorite games of all time. It's not perfect, it can drag on the scenes for too long, the story can be confusing at times, and Gravemind sucks on Legendary. Brutes. But it's good, trust me, I'm not being nostalgic, go play it, fuck! Try to do more Halo videos down the line if I feel like it.